First tonight at 6, 5 Investigates uncovers troubling details about a school bus company. The company refused to cooperate with investigators while parents frantically search for their children.
We first told you about Pride Transportation earlier this month after a school bus disappeared with elementary students on it for hours. Crystal Bowie tells us why the bus company is still operating despite an alarming safety record.
We dug into 3 years' worth of records for Pride Transportation and found they put untrained drivers behind the wheel and repeatedly failed safety inspections.
The list of violations goes on.
One of the main leaf springs is broken.
And on.
The brake master cylinder switch was loose.
And on.
The emergency exit handle was broken.
In just 3 years, more than 40 school buses owned and operated by Pride Transportation failed safety inspections by the Minnesota State Patrol.
They don't perform very well.
We found buses repeatedly pulled out of service for bad brakes and non-working safety equipment.
I have serious concerns about this company. I do not think that they're operating vehicles or their fleet as safely as they should be.
Lieutenant Brian Rue says the average fail rate for school bus companies is around 10%, but Pride Transportation failed nearly 60% of its inspections.
Is that typical for bus companies?
No, it's concerning anytime we see inspection results that drastic.
And those drastic results have come even though State Patrol gives school bus companies a 30-day notice before they show up for inspection.
When you know we're coming, we're giving you the days. Most carriers put a lot of effort and take pride in their fleet and in their operation and the job that they're doing to transport students.
We started investigating Pride Transportation earlier this month after a bus disappeared for 3 hours.
We're just assuming she has dropped off at some other city, wandering around, wondering where she is at.
As panicked families and police tried to find the missing students,
excuse me, sir.
The bus company,
can you tell us what happened?
Refused to answer our questions.
I'm from 5 Eyewitness News, and there was a girl that was stuck on the bus. Why are you not letting us know what happened?
The driver eventually said he was lost on his first day on the job. When audited by State Patrol this May, troopers found Pride Transportation put drivers behind the wheel who didn't have all of the necessary certification or training. One bus driver didn't even have a valid background check. The company has refused to comment on these findings.
There's nothing that indicates they're changing the way they're operating, which is what gets to be frustrating for us.
And despite the troubling safety record, there's not much else the state can do. While commercial bus companies are regulated by the Minnesota Department of Transportation and can be shut down for repeated safety violations, school bus companies are regulated by DPS.
We are limited to what we can do statutorily, where our authority is. The legislatures, the lawmakers want to pursue any changes. That's certainly one avenue to look at.
As long as Pride Transportation signs off on paperwork saying they've corrected the issues, state police will have to take the company at their word until the next inspection. Now at the state level, repeated violations can eventually get misdemeanor citations, but those fines aren't usually more than $200. State troopers say if parents feel more concerns, they need to push the schools to reevaluate the bus companies their schools have contracts with.